Pretty impressive stuff, Dave.
Really is. Chakaev doing a wonderful job going to the body. And Sweeney is facing two problems. One, this bout could end early with the 20-point rule. And two, he may feel this bout for a week. These body shots have been tremendous, and they've set up to good head shots. A guy himself who's been used to getting opponents out of there now finds himself on pace to lose by 20 unless he can step it up a little bit here. And he is trying.
Yeah, make no mistake about that. John Sweeney is out there and staying toe-to-toe with Chakaev. He just doesn't have the power that Rakim has.
Chakaev is formidable. If you're Sweeney, you've done a good job to get here. You've won while you were here. But sometimes you just go against the wall. The guy is better. That's why you're in the round of 16. In the meantime, for Sweeney, although it's late now, a jab would have been a good idea. But here you go. You're Sweeney. You've bloodied the nose of your opponent. You've taken some physical measure of him. They also work on the equipment. And yet you're down 13 points.
Well, let's see if Sweeney tries to flick that jab instead of tying up with Chakaev and trying to match his power, which is not the thing to do with this man.
We have a decision in ring B.
And despite
and
the numbers
in this bout,
this is one where I wouldn't mind if they said, okay, four rounds are over, forget the numbers. We're going to turn this into a street fight and let these guys lean on each other and see who wins over 12 rounds.
That would be fun.
I'd love to see that because this is a good, gritty, inside battle. It's another story being told that's not being told in the numbers.
You know, and I guarantee you, if you ask both the fighters, both Rakim and John, they'd probably go for it.
Yeah. The two guys showing a ton of heart on the inside. And it's fun to watch. Probably the only people who would be chagrined would be Sweeney's coaching staff. Saying, you know, if the other guy can out-muscle you, go with the jab, try to get the cheap points, move a little bit.
No question about Big John Sweeney's heart, that's for sure. He has stayed toe-to-toe with Rakim Chakaev and hasn't backed off an inch. Hasn't scored a lot of punches, but he hasn't backed off.
Class, in the red corner, representing Germany, Alexander Pavlov.
Talk about the idea that there are other ways to get to Beijing if you lose here. And what you have to learn here in a bout, if the other guy comes out and gets a big first round, it teaches you for the next trial how to come out and make a fast start. Key thing is to take lessons out of here. And they are your building blocks.
That is the end of round three. Rakim Chakaev has had it all his way in this bout. He has a 21-4 lead.
And Chakaev doing most of his good work to the body first, and then goes to the head. And there's a guy that just wants to wear you down and figure that the numbers will take care of themselves. He's been correct.
The only thing that Sweeney's probably been able to do is maybe deviate Rakim's septum there. Little bloody nose.
Well, look at that. It's a landslide in every round. Which is also something that if you're in the Chakaev corner, you love to look back and see that this has been spread and that you've contained each round and done well inside of each round. That's how the champions progress.
Final 2 minutes, heavyweight division, 91 kilograms. John Sweeney of Ireland in the red and Rakim Shakiev of Russia. Sweeney almost walked into one there. Two more blows land by the Russian.
Well, Sweeney should just come out in round four and make sure he gets his. Whatever happens, make sure you get some shots in and try to carry something away.
You want to tell Shakiev, okay, you may have beat me, but you're going to remember who I was and remember my name.
I'm going to take something out of this bout. And then if you're Sweeney, we hope you do something well. And then the guy that beat you goes and wins it all. And then in your mind, it puts you that much closer to the top.
Here in the round of 16, Shakiev will no doubt advance. In fact, we have yet to see a Russian boxer lose here in Chicago. They came over here very, very strong.
And showing versatility. Seen some excellent Russian southpaws. Here, we're seeing a quick, body-punching-minded heavyweight who has the right technique to go all the way. Quickness in the heavyweight division is a rare commodity. If you could parlay that, use your other skills. You're doing quite well, and this is an exceptional performance in the round of 16, 28-5 at this point.
Over a guy from Ireland who's got some skills. Just overmatched from a power standpoint, I think.
They both had the same idea, but one guy executed it a lot better.
And that is it. John Sweeney of Ireland gave it his best shot, but in the end, he winds up on the losing end of a 28-5 deficit. The winner by a decision, Rakim Shakiev of Russia.
What I come away from this is hats off to the work ethic of Shakiev. Work that body continuously in this bout, and the score did take care of itself. You out-muscle a guy, work him enough to the body, you'll slow him enough where other things happen for you.
In the 91-kilogram weight class, the winner...
You know, you look at John Sweeney, he looks a little bit like Jerry Cooney when you're compared to Ken Norton. Shakiev, obviously a guy who spends a lot of time in the weight room.
And he's quite a machine and quite a formidable object in this tournament. He'll go very far.
Rakim Shakiev advances to the next round.